the post-harvest is the second step of the cocoa production after the farmer grow on the field. Without any good practices in the post-processing and post-harvest handling, it cannot be produced the good cocoa later on.
The cocoa fermentation is the first processing step after the cocoa fruit is harvested, and in fact it is the most crucial step when it comes to flavor potential development. But if this fermentation goes wrong, there is no cacao flavor. If it goes right, we can bring out the best cacao flavor that you can have in the final product.
Bé, normalment el cacau correctament fermentat és, per mi, el que està equilibrat, sense regustos de sobrefermentat, o sigui, notes de salami o de pernil salat, o de notes de proteïna fermentada, vaja, que no hi hagi notes, per descomptant, ni de putrefacció. Això indicaria que no ha estat sobrefermentat i, en canvi, que no té tampoc punts astringents, que voldria dir que s'han condensat correctament, el polifenol s'ha eliminat i no hi ha astringència. Això seria el cacau fermentat al punt. Llavors, el sabor que tingui un cacau fermentat en aquest punt és el que té aquella fava en el seu moment òptim de fermentació.
If you think about the post-harvest, that's really due to different places, because post-harvest is about fermentations and drying. And you have places where they do sun drying, and places, this is mainly in West Africa, and places where they don't have enough sun. So like, for example, in Indonesia, we have sometimes 3,000 millimeters of rain per year. It's difficult to teach the farmer, so to train the farmer on doing sun drying if really the conditions are not favorable. So obviously then the manuals or the instruction, they are completely different. There are some farmers that they really believe in what they do. They will never sell cocoa if it's not well fermented under the sun drying. They don't get humidity around 8, or they don't have the nice crunchy noise when they keep it in the hands. It's difficult to generalize. I think every place has to have its own tailor-made manual somehow, with a strong social and anthropological impact.
Biji kakao di sini. Jadi kalau kita hanya mengandalkan sinar matahari, ya kalau matahari itu kita terik terus, seumpama kita nanti ada mendung atau musim hujan, kita akan memerlukan mekanik, istilahnya dryer ini.